We shall discuss why the lander of Chandrayaan 2, Vikram, failed and what changes have been made in Chandrayaan 3 lander to rectify them. In a recent lecture at IISC Bangalore, critical insights were shared regarding the technical intricacies of the lunar landing attempt, and we're here to unpack it all for you. In a comprehensive S. Pradeep Memorial Lecture, Dr. S. Somnath, current director of ISRO, delved deep into the technicalities and the lessons learned from Chandrayaan 2's landing. I was inspired to make the video from a recent upload by the YouTube channel, Gareeb Scientist. Link to that video in the description. But before we proceed, let's establish a foundation by understanding two fundamental concepts in space exploration: attitude and trajectory. Attitude in the context of space refers to the spacecraft's orientation or the direction it is looking. It involves aspects like pitch, yaw, and roll angles. Let's go through them briefly. The pitch of a spacecraft refers to its rotation around the horizontal axis, causing its nose to move up or down. This angle affects the spacecraft's orientation in space, influencing its trajectory and positioning during maneuvers and operations. And the term, yaw, refers to the rotational movement of a spacecraft around its vertical axis. It's akin to the side-to-side motion of a vehicle's steering wheel, controlling the left or right orientation of the spacecraft in space. Finally, the roll angle of a spacecraft refers to its rotation around its longitudinal axis. Imagine the spacecraft as an arrow. Then the roll angle would represent the arrow's spin. This rotation is important for orienting the spacecraft and controlling its position in space. All these variables together decide the trajectory of a spacecraft. Let's look into that. A trajectory is the path followed by an object in motion, typically in a gravitational field. It's determined by the initial velocity, direction, and external forces acting on the object, defining its course through space and time. Further, the trajectory of a lander is not a simple straight-down path. It follows a curved trajectory while descending. This is a crucial factor as it affects both horizontal and vertical velocities. Now, how does a lander control its velocity? There are two velocities or speeds we need to control. This is crucial for a successful landing. One is horizontal, meaning it takes you parallel to the surface of the moon. Another is vertical, meaning it will take you towards or away from the surface. There is a key difference between these two speeds. Gravity, or in this case, lunar gravity, can only affect the vertical speed, not the horizontal one. So, when thrusters are fired to reduce the vertical speed, which takes gravity into account, it will reduce the speed as required. However, when we adjust the horizontal velocity, the vertical also changes due to gravity. A good thruster combination manages these two to keep the spacecraft on track. So, the question arises, can a lander effectively balance these velocities to achieve its mission? Chandrayaan 2's goal was to land in a specific 500 by 500 meter area at a 70 degree south lunar latitude. Chandrayaan 2's lander, Vikram, was in a 30 by 100 kilometer orbit before its descent. This phase was carefully planned before the lunar landing attempt. However, challenges arose during the rough braking phase as the lander transitioned from 30 kilometers to around 8 to 7 kilometers above the lunar surface. Here, the lander uses an inertial navigation system. An inertial navigation system, INS, is a vital component of a spacecraft's guidance and navigation system. It relies on internal sensors such as gyros and accelerometers to calculate its position, orientation, and velocity without relying on external references like GPS. By measuring changes in acceleration and rotation, the INS continuously updates its information to provide accurate navigation data, even when external signals are unavailable, making it crucial for space missions where traditional navigation methods might be compromised. This technology enables spacecraft to autonomously determine their position and direction, ensuring precision in various phases of their journey. This phase is critical, as the lander's instruments need accurate calibration for a precise landing. The camera coasting phase plays a pivotal role in calibrating the lander's instruments, including the camera, laser altimeter, and radio altimeter to ensure a soft landing. Vikram's attitude was locked during this phase to ensure smooth calibration. As the lander approached closer to the lunar surface, the actual trajectory line diverged from the planned path. This divergence was the beginning of the crucial turning point in the mission. Then, the question arises, what went wrong? The combination of factors led to an unfavorable outcome. The thrust of the engine was more than expected, which can happen, but it was supposed to be corrected in the next stage. The decision to lock the lander's attitude during the camera coasting phase meant the lander had no control over the speed it was moving. In the next stage, which was the fine braking stage, in order to correct the error, the lander had to turn. Here comes the second problem. The rotational speed of the lander was fixed at 10 degrees per second. This was not fast enough to correct all the errors accumulated so far. As errors accumulated, the trajectory changed. In addition to this, the internal clock on the lander was a second off. ISRO chief stated if the timer had a few more seconds, the lander might have been successful. In day-to-day life, it would not matter, but here, it led to the loss of life. This error alone might not have the capability to topple the mission, but it acted as the cherry on the cake. Learning about this made me realize how slight errors accumulate into big disasters. Chernobyl is one of the cases that come to my mind. However, there was some error on the part of the scientists involved in the project. But none of these can explain why contact was interrupted between ISRO and Vikram Lander, as you can see in this video.
Vikram Lander descent was as planned and normal performance was observed up to an altitude of 2.1 km. Subsequently, the communications from the lander to ground station was lost. The data is being analyzed.
I got to know about the sabotage angle from this video. It has been linked below. Let's talk about it briefly. It's evident that ISRO's systems encountered compromise prior to September 3, 2019. Concurrently, a network intrusion transpired during Chandrayaan 2's lander descent to the moon's surface between September 8 and September 9, 2019. This infection persisted even 2 months later. This situation raises the potential of sabotage during Chandrayaan 2's landing attempt, potentially orchestrated by hacker groups Lazarus and Group B linked to North Korea. However, we must explore alternative scenarios. Stuxnet, an American malware, disrupted Iranian nuclear facilities. Interestingly, its most significant impact may be in India, suggesting varied possibilities involving foreign-made microprocessors with hidden backdoors. While considering these scenarios, the North Koreans remain a strong contender in this scenario. Well, ISRO has learned from it and made the necessary changes to ensure Chandrayaan 3 is a success. The landing area, which was 500 meters by 500 meters for Chandrayaan 2, has been increased to 4 kilometers by 4 kilometers. Changes include increasing the lander's attitude rate change to 25 degrees per second and enabling instantaneous thrust control during all phases. Moreover, the thruster can react more quickly as its response time has been reduced. To enhance navigation accuracy, instruments like the laser Doppler velocimeter have been added. It can measure velocity in all directions. Improvements in the lander's legs to enhance landing stability, which can now handle 3 meters per second speed. There are many more tweaks in the software segments. These changes in Chandrayaan 3 reflect a shift towards a more failure-based approach, aiming for a safer and more successful lunar landing. But this time, it's a race. Russians are trying to overtake us with their Luna 25 mission. Watch this video to know more about the same.